Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 14 has some great customization options, and so I wanted to show you how you can customize your phone to look just like this or any other setup that you would choose. And you can see I have custom icons as well as custom widgets, and everything just looks a little bit different. So let me show you how to do that step by step. Now, the first thing is, if you've already been using iOS 14 for a while, you know that you have this new app library. Now, you can't get rid of the app library, but you can get rid of all your pages. You can add all your pages back, have this custom page, whatever you would like. So if you want to change that, just press on an empty space and get into jiggle mode. Tap on the dots at the bottom, and then you can see all of your different pages. You can see this was one of my previous pages. As soon as I hit done, it will lock into place and I can bring that page back. So you can have customized multiple pages depending on what you want to set up. So let's press and hold again, tap, get rid of that. And as you can see, we're back in jiggle mode. Now, in addition to using the app library and hiding home screens, if you want to use a home screen, but don't want an application to show up on that home screen, but you still want to keep it, you can press and hold on it and then hit remove app and then say move to app library. Now it will stay in the app library and no longer show on your home screens. So now it's in my app library under travel, and I can just open it from there. Now, if you want to have customized widgets like this, the first thing you need to do is install an application called WidgetSmith, as you can see here. Now, once you have WidgetSmith installed, it allows you to fully customize any one of these widgets. So let's go into WidgetSmith. Now, within the application WidgetSmith, we have the option to add small widgets, medium widgets, or large widgets. And so we can pick whatever we'd like. Let's just pick a small one. So we'll add a small one, tap on the widget, and tap on it again. And as you can see, we have some different options. So we have time, date, both of them combined. We've got some photos, calendar, reminders. And as you get further down, you can pay for additional widgets, but everything I'm going to show you is free. So let's go ahead and pick maybe a photo. If we pick a photo, tap on selected photos, then choose a photo. And let's just choose this red one, go back, hit save, and then go home. Now, if we want to add a widget, press and hold, hit plus, and let's scroll down to WidgetSmith. So we've got WidgetSmith, and then we can add small, medium, or large, whatever we choose. We'll pick small, add widget, and you'll see it added it there in the upper left. And then of course, if we press and hold, we can move this around. Now, if you're good with Photoshop, of course, you could blend this with the background, make it add or make it fit in. And then when you press on it, you can have it open your calendar, or go back to tools and select any one of these to open. So maybe you want to open health or photos or weather, which requires a premium subscription, but we want it to open our calendar. So super simple, tap on it, it opens the calendar. So that's one way you can customize. Now you can see I have a few different options here, but then I have customized app icons as well. And this is done a little bit differently. Now, in order to customize app icons, you need to download the actual app icon. I'll link those in the description so you can grab all of these if you'd like to use the exact same ones. They're sort of a dark theme version of what we already have. And they sort of work, but they work through shortcuts. And so, for example, if I want to go into Safari, press on it, it opens shortcuts and then opens apple.com on Safari. Now you could change this to any web page, you can change what it does, but if you're familiar with shortcuts, it's pretty simple to do. If not, let me show you how to do it step by step. Now let's go into shortcuts. And within shortcuts, you can see I have reminders and maps and music and Safari. Let me show you how I made the Safari one. So you'll be able to add a dark icon or any icon that you would like. So we'll go back over to shortcuts, hit the plus, tap add action, tap on apps, and within apps, find the app that you want to change. So Safari in this case, and then in Safari, I just have it open a URL. That's the easiest way. You could use any one of these, but we'll do open URL, tap on URL, and we'll type apple.com. Now you won't have to modify this for every single one of these. Hit next. Name the shortcut. I'll just name it Safari 2 since I've already made one, and hit done. Now, once you've done this, tap the three dots and then tap the three dots again for the menu and tap add to home screen. Once you've tapped on add to home screen, tap the icon here, then tap choose photo. And under choose photo, let's find Safari, choose Safari, hit add, hit done, and you'll find it on our home screen over here. And so if we tap on this, it will open up and move over to apple.com. Now, because it's named Safari 2, of course, I would need to go back in and change that, but we can name that whatever we'd like, photos, music, whatever we'd like, we can change it to that. And so you can build those for every single one of these. So camera, for example, runs a shortcut and then opens the camera. So some of these don't work really well. So if I go to phone, you'll see that it says, who do you want to call? So it's not exactly what you want it to do. So not every one of these will work, but you can fully customize it however you'd like. Now I've shown you how you can customize your phone to look like this, but maybe you want to change it up a little bit and you want a different style widget. Well, there's another app as well other than WidgetSmith. So if we pull down, you can see there's one called Color Widgets. If we go into Color Widgets, this is a little bit different in that it shows not only the date and time, but also the battery percentage. So if you have a Face ID phone and you want to see the percentage all the time, you can do that now without having to pull down the control center. So for example, we'll tap on this widget, we'll edit the widget, and here we can change the background from light, dark, or colored, and then also change the font. So maybe I'll make the font like this, and then also I'll add a photo. And let's add a red photo to match the background. We'll hit set widget. And now if we go home, let's press and hold, we'll remove the old widget. Let's add a new one. Go to our color widget and then go to the medium sized and hit add widget. And now it matches the background. And of course we can change this over and over to whatever works best for us. So as you can see, it says 84%. If we pull down control center, you'll see it says 84%. So now we have our battery status. Of course, this can be smaller, larger, and however you'd like. So the possibilities are fairly endless as far as customization overall with this particular update. So iOS 14 allows for a lot of customization, and I think I'll leave mine like this for a little while and see if I like it. But let me know what you've done with your iOS 14 home screen in the comments below. Now, additionally, this app widget here is Lumi. This is actually an application that lets you know when the best time to take photos is, and it has a watch complication as well. So I've set it on my Apple Watch, and you can see my Apple Watch, the Series 6 in red with a black titanium band, matches my phone. So I've kind of customized everything to match. And then of course I know when to take the best photos. So it's Lumi. That's an application. That's actually not a free app, but I can link that in the description as well if you're interested. Now, of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description along with all the different app icons. So I'll link to the person that provided those. There's a great place you can download every single one of the dark themed icons, and then you can set them for yourself if you'd like to. So I'll link all that in the description. And then, of course, again, let me know what you've done with these app icons or your home screen in the comments below. And also, if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.